Now that we have most of our website features in place, let's take a look at another important feature, that is creating blogs. We'll assume we want to write about 10 blog posts a month, and we want those posts to act like a blog. In this video, we'll be setting up a blog section for our website. Let's take a look at how the blog section looks like in the custom Umbraco template, which we are going to use as a reference for this video. The top part looks like the master template content. In the middle, there's a featured blog post here. And below that, there's a collection of the latest blog post. And this is what we're going to use as a reference point for our video. To recreate this page, we'll need two new document types with template and a query builder to iterate through all the available blog posts and render them out in the grid we have here. I've set up everything we need to get started, so let's take a look. There are two new document types with template called blog and blog item. The blog document type has the title box composition and the featured story with a content picker as its property, while the blog item consists of the title box composition, blog metadata such as the author name, published on, categories, and thumbnail image, and a content group with intro text and body text fields. For these document types to appear as notes in the content section, I've set the permissions in the blog document type to include the blog item as its child node. And in the homepage document type, I've set the permission to include blog as its child node. Moving on to the template section, in the templates folder, I've nested both the blog and the blog item template under the master template. For both the templates, I've taken the HTML structure from the blog.html and blogpost.html file from the custom Umbraco template folder and made sure that all properties are rendering out in the right places. Let's check out the content section. I've added the blog page down here under the welcome page. All the fields in the blog page are filled in and the blog items are nested below it. As we can have multiple blog items, there is a possibility that our content tree will grow very large. To avoid this and display all our blog items under the blog post in a list view, we can enable the list view feature. Let's do it. We'll navigate to the blog document type and go to the list view tab. We'll toggle enable list view and save the document type. All right, now let's go back to the content section and refresh it. As you can see, the blog items are no longer nested under the blog node. Instead, they are listed right here, currently in a grid. This can be changed easily to a list view from here. Let's take a look at one of the blog posts. I've filled in the required fields here as well. Now it's time to take a look at the front end. So we'll go back and click on the info tab and select the published link. And this is how our blog page looks currently. We have a featured story up here and the collection of blog posts down here. But this grid is still displaying the static content from the template and does not render a blog post. To render a blog post, we'll have to build a query. So let's get to it. To add a query, we need to go to the blog template. So in the templates folder, we'll select the blog template and look for a comment indicating where to add the query. And here it is. We'll place our cursor here, add a few lines, and click on the Query Builder button up here, which opens up a dialog. And this is where we need to filter on our content pages using the blog item document type. So up here, I'll say I want content of type blog item. And in the From field, I'll select blog page from the content tree. So this means that we only want pages using the blog item document type and nested under the blog page. Then we can specify even further by filtering by created date, ID, last updated date, or name. And we can choose how the items should be ordered. For now, I'll select order by created date and in descending order. Below here, you'll notice which items are returned from the query we just configured. Looks like we've done it correctly, as these are the four blog posts we have on the site. And finally, down here is the actual query. Now, let's submit the query. I'll just move this in a little bit. You'll notice that along with the query up here, a for each statement is also added. This is what will iterate through all the items that is found in the query. By default, the query is using an unordered list, but we want to use the HTML from our custom Umbraco template in order to make it look pretty. So instead of the UL tag up here, we want our row division from down here. So I'll copy it and paste it up here and close it down as well. Alright then, instead of the list item here, I'll use the call division from down and render the appropriate values. I'll copy the entire div class and paste it here below the li tag. Next, I'll add a variable to hold the image we need from the thumbnail image field using the iPublishedContent property. I'll now update the link tag with the link to the blog post. To render the thumbnail image, I'll pass the thumbnail.url value. And finally, I'll render the title property. I've used item.value here because we are inside the for each query block. Alright, I'll just clean this template up a little bit. And get rid of the static blog post down here. I think that looks clean now. Let's save the template and head over to the front end and see how it looks. There we go. We are now rendering our blog post here in the latest story section. And if we click on one of them, it takes us to the actual blog post in here. So we've added more flexibility to our website. So far, we've built a website using both basic and a bit more advanced features in Umbraco. But what about the navigation menu up here? None of these links work, and they are not the content pages we've created in the back office. Don't worry, we'll find out about it in the next video, where we'll finally create a proper navigation menu for our site using partial views. So, see you in the next video.